In this video, I'm going to talk about 5 different methods to power an IP camera. We can use AC power source, which is the most common solution before. And we can use the PoE, power over Ethernet. It's quite convenient for a professional project. We also can use the battery just for the temporary deployment. And there's solar panel power system. At last, we also will discuss how we can send the power together with the fiber optic cable. This is the fiber optic cable. It can provide fast speed, low latency, and long distance run. But we cannot inject the power into a fiber optic cable. So we have the solution. You still can power the camera while you're using the fiber optic cable. Okay, now let's get started. The first method is the AC power. But most IP cameras work with the low voltage DC. We need to use this power adapter. It will convert the AC power to low voltage DC, so we can power an IP camera. It is a little bit hassle. We need to have the power source available at each of the camera. Moreover, we also need to use this UTP cable to connect the camera to a router or switch to have the data exchange, so we can have both power and data available. But this is the major solution before the PoE entered the market. Today, we are still using the power data, but for a different camera, like this Wi-Fi camera. We can connect the camera to a router, Wi-Fi router, through this Wi-Fi connection. So there's no need for a UTP cable. We just need to have the AC power data. And sometimes it's quite difficult to pull the cable from the camera to the router, especially the router is staying in the middle of the house. So that's why the Wi-Fi camera is so popular in the home application. But personally, I don't prefer the Wi-Fi camera. The reason is the video quality is depend on the Wi-Fi coverage around the setup spot. If the Wi-Fi signal is not strong enough, you may see in the choppy video. I prefer the PoE solution if it is really possible to pull the cable from the camera to the router or the switch. Okay, now let's move to the second solution, PoE. Power over Ethernet allow us to use single Ethernet cable to send both power and data from the PoE switch to the edge device. What's that supposed to mean? It means we don't need to have power source available at each of the camera. We just need to put the Ethernet cable from the switch to each of the camera setup spot, make the connection, then we can get the whole system up. Now let me just make a quick setup. This is the connector from the camera. Alright, we connect another end to one of the PoE port. You can see the power indicator is on. That means this switch is providing the power to this camera. Also, the data exchange. It's quite convenient, right? This is the low voltage power over this K5 Ethernet cable, so it's quite safe. Also, there's 4 steps in the standard PoE. Before this PoE switch send the power to the edge device, it will just verify your edge device is also support PoE. If this is the PC computer or non-PoE equipment, you connect the device to one of the port. If not, send the power. The second step is the PoE will classify, just determine what is the maximum power budget you need to send. Then it will start monitoring the status. If there anything happened, abnormal happened, the PoE switch will disconnect the power. It will shut down the power automatically. So this is also called power handshaking. It's quite safe to use the POE's technology. There are one tip about the cable. When we use the POE, the cable is critical. It's better to use the cable which is made of 100% copper. The thing is, now we are not only sending the data, but also the power. So if we use the CCA Titan low cost cable, it's going to generate a serious power loss, especially you have the long run between the camera and the POE switch. Alright, now let's move to the next method about the battery. This is an uncommon solution. Why people will use the battery to power an IP camera? After all, the battery only can keep the camera running for a few days before we need to recharge or swap the battery. But it still could be the value solution, especially when we want to deploy the camera temporarily. This is a bird box camera. Usually we'll put this camera in a bird box and watch the birds on the mobile phone or tablet. We only need this camera running during the birding season. After that, we may remove the camera from the birdhouse. And this is the motorcycle battery. I think the motorcycle battery is the best solution because we have different kind of value. If we are using like a 6 amp DC 12 voltage battery, it can supply about 15 days, 2 weeks for this camera running. The setup is pretty simple. We just need to connect this cable. Don't mix up because there's a positive and negative. If we just mix up the connection, it's going to fire the camera directly. And here we got the second, the connector of the cable. What we need to do is just connect the camera. Then we can power up the camera. It will be always the Wi-Fi camera. If you already pull the cable from UTP cable from the camera to a router or switch, there's no point to use the battery because you can just use the POE technology to send the power from the router or the switch to the camera. Alright, now let's move to another solution, solar panel power system. This is a basic component for a solar power system. We need to have a solar panel. The solar panel will convert the sunlight to a DC power, and the power will be saved to this battery inventory. We cannot connect a solar panel to a camera directly to supply the power for the camera. It's going to damage the camera if you just connect the solar panel to a camera. The output voltage from the solar panel can raise up to 18 watts, and the camera only can take in a 12 volt. And also, the power generated by this solar panel is not enough to keep the camera running. So we need to have the battery to save the energy, and the battery will continue to supply the power for the camera. So it's the first tricky thing for a solar panel system is you need to reserve enough battery to keep the power. So even there's a raining day for several days, you still have enough power to keep this camera running. And this is the solar charger. Usually we will connect the solar panel to this charger, also connect this battery to the charger, so the charger will control the charging process to determine whether this battery is being full charged or not. Also, we will connect the camera to this charge controller, so the charge controller will supply the power for this camera. So in the practical setup, if you can have the regulator, it will be best. The regulator is supposed to sit in between the camera and the output of this charger. So the regulator can regulate the power, the voltage to DC 12 voltage. You see, when we charge this battery, the voltage will dynamically change depending on the voltage input from this solar panel. That is the reason why I would recommend that you add the power regulator between the output of this charger and the camera, so you can have the stable voltage to this camera. Alright, and let's just move to the last method. You can use the fiber optic cable, also send the power to the camera. This is the camera system over the fiber optic cable. Here we have the pre-made fiber optic cable. With the fiber optic cable, we can have a usual long run. But the drawback with the fiber optic cable is we cannot inject power into the fiber optic cable. Basically, this fiber optic cable is just the glasses. So in this setup, I just put another power coat in parallel to send this DC power from the network video recorder to the camera. And this is the outdoor media converter. It will convert the power and output the standard PoE. Here we are using the standard PoE to power this IP camera. If you want to learn more about how to set up this system, you can reference my another video.